Yes. So a quick recap. We have read that how when Kezia, she was suggested by her grandmother to prepare a birthday gift for her father, she committed a huge mistake. She disappointed her father because she had torn some important papers of her father. And then one day it happened that she also felt that how it was a complaining attitude, that she complained to her grandmother that by God he made fathers, why he had made fathers, and she began to actually tremble at the sight of her father. She even saw her neighbors, Mr. McDonald, whom she found playing with the children. They looked very happy there. The father, he was not getting angry at the activities of the children. Instead, he was enjoying with them. And she started comparing both the fathers. And she thought that there were different kinds of fathers. And her own father, he was very rude towards her. And he did not even love her. And after a few days, Kezia's mother, she became ill. And Kezia's grandmother, she took her to the hospital. Kezia was alone in the house with Alice, who is the cook. And Kezia was, she had to sleep alone at night. And Alice warned Kezia that she should not scream, even if she had a bad dream, even if she had a nightmare. But when Kezia was sleeping alone in her bedroom, she had a horrible dream. The dream was that there was a butcher with a knife and the butcher was coming close to her. She could not move. She was so terrified that she gave a loud cry. And she screamed. But when she opened her eyes, she saw that her father, he was in the room. He was holding a candle in his hand. He blew the candle out and then he lifted Kezia in his arms and he took Kezia into his bedroom there. There, Kezia, she was lying with her father there. The father also asked her to rub her feet with his body so that she could make it warm, so she could get some warmth there with that. And Kezia, she was lost in thoughts. And the father was extremely tired. He was already fast asleep. When she was lying close to her father, she could feel the roughness of the father's skin. And she thought that her father was harder than the grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. The hardness did not bother her at that time. She felt comfortable in the company of her father. And there we find a great transformation in Kezia's thinking, in her behavior. She thought that her father had to work hard and he came in the evening tired. He was too tired to play with her at that time. And she felt that it was not her father's fault. He had to work hard for the family. And at that time, she also realized her mistake, that how it was her fault that she had torn those important papers. And that's why she got that punishment. And then what she said, let me read it out from here, paragraph number 12. The tired out, he slept before the little girl. A funny feeling came over her. Poor father, not so big after all, with no one to look after him. He was harder than grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. And every day he had to work hard and was too tired to be Mr. McDonald. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. Thinking this, she stirred suddenly and sighed. "What's the matter?" asked her father. "Another dream." "Oh," said the little girl, "my head's on your heart. I can hear it going. What a big heart you have got, father dear." And at that moment, we see that how Kezia is no longer afraid of her father now. She was lying very comfortably with her father there, and the fear was gone. Because she realized this aspect that her father was also not different from Mr. McDonald, but it was just that he had to work hard, and because of that, he was too tired to play with her in the evening. She realized her mistake of tearing those papers, and that's why she felt that he was a poor father who needed someone to look after him. There was no one to look after him. He was also not so big after all. उसको उनको भी देखभाल की जरूरत है. And she felt this way for her father. And thus, she stirred a little. She moved a little while lying. So when the father asked that what the matter was, she replied that, saying that her head was on her heart and she could feel the throbbing of the heart, the heartbeat. She could feel it. जब वो पिता के पास लेटी हुई थी वो अपने पिता के दिल की धड़कनों को सुन पा रही थी. एंड वो कहती है, व्हाट अ बिग हार्ट यू हैव गॉट फादर डियर. सो यहाँ पर वो महसूस करती है कि उसके पिता का दिल भी बहुत खूबसूरत है, उनके पिता का दिल भी बहुत बड़ा है. एंड शी रियलाइज दैट हर फादर ऑल्सो लव्ड हर वेरी मच. एंड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द स्टोरी The Little Girl, written by Catherine Mansfield. She's the author of the story. I hope you all like this story and you all have understood what was the meaning of the introductory discussion that we did, the video that I had shown you. You can also relate Kezia's story with your life somewhere when your parents, they become angry, they scold you. Sometimes you are scared. But you also must know this thing that your parents love you a lot. They love you dearly, more than anything in this world. You are everything to your parents. So whenever they scold you, don't take it too hard on your heart. Dil pe mat lagao unki baaton. Right? Now I want you to answer, what is the takeaway from this chapter? What you have learned? What is your observation from the story? After that, we will go for the discussion of the question. You cannot unmute yourself because I will be unmuting you. So kindly keep your hands raised to give the input. Just give me a minute. Yes. Yes, Narinder, share your views.
Yes. Oh, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Yes, ma'am, in this chapter, as we have studied that Kezia was afraid of father, we can just learn that sometimes parents were like, they may not express their feelings like about us, and they may not express their feelings, but they love us more than like anybody else. Sometimes they won't express that, but somewhere or the other, they like, you know, care for us.
Yes,
the most.
They care for us. Yes, of course. Correct. Yes, Vidya. Yes, Vidya. Wait. Hanji, you can unmute.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Vidya.
Ma'am, from this chapter, we learned that Kezia was a little girl, but her father was very strict. So this shows us that our parents may be strict for some time. So because of our, for our good only, they want us to do the things correctly. And from this chapter, we see that Kezia's father was angry on her just because she made mistakes sometimes. So they get angry just to correct our mistakes so that we do not repeat them in future. And they are very, it's not like that. They're always angry on us and they're strict, but they are emotionally attached to us. They do not express their emotions, but they love us very much, but sometimes we fail to understand them.
Yes, of course. Keep your hands raised, Peter. Yes, Himanshi, now you can share your views. Unmute yourself.
From this chapter, we learn that we can, the means parents cannot express their feeling by only by love. They also express their feeling by scolding their children and beating them. That is also love by their to their children. And it is Kezia do some little mistakes. So she was scolded and beaten by his father. Mm-hmm. And they also beat us because of our mistakes. And we should learn from these mistakes. So they beat us so that and scold us so that we shouldn't do that mistake again.
Yes, that is for your good only, that they scold you, they punish you sometimes, right? Yes. Who else want to speak? What is your takeaway from the chapter? What did you learn? What you have observed? Anything else? Guneet, unmute and tell me what you have learned from the chapter. No, nothing? Harshit, roll number 43, Harshit. No one wants to talk. Dikshant, can you unmute and speak? No one is interested. Yes, Vansh. You are unmuted.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I am audible.
Yes.
Ma'am, from this, the takeaway from this chapter is that parents love their children so much, but they don't express. They sometimes care for us and get over authoritative for us, but also love us. The scolding should not be taken as they are trying to.
Okay. Anything?
As they are.
Okay, take care.
We should take good things from them.
Yes, you should try to understand them.
Their feelings.
Okay, take care. Thank you. Ishita.
Yes, ma'am. From this chapter, the takeaway of this chapter is that ki parents love their children from the bottom of their heart, and their strictness. They scold us for the betterment, and that in the future we their strictness help us for a betterment in the future.
Okay.
We should not take their their strictness on our heart, and we should realize our mistakes rather.
Okay, good one. Chaliye. Next is Anshika there in the list. Anshika, yes, you can unmute.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, parents are always loving to their children and they never scold their children. Whenever they scold their children, they scold them for their betterment only. They never beat the children to hurt them. This will show results in our future only.
Okay. Now we can also interpret the takeaway in different way, like this way, that how parents, they do work for the betterment of their children. They are continuously busy with their jobs and business as well. And sometimes they do not have sufficient time for their kids. And then what happens is, sometimes they do avoid their children, they scold them, they punish them as well. But these things create a gap. Bitterness creeps in their mutual relations. Why? Because sometimes the children, they fail to understand the parent. And sometimes parents also, they don't understand their children. So it is important that both should try to bridge the gap. ये जो gap create होता है, जो करवाहट आ जाती है, जब parents डांटते हैं, punishments देते हैं, बच्चों को लगने लगता है हमारे parents तो हमसे प्यार ही नहीं करते. वो हमारे बारे में सोचते ही नहीं है. सो इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट चिल्ड्रन शुड ऑल्सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, एंड इफ अ गैप इज एक्चुअली टेकिंग प्लेस देयर a bridge is being formed, you should try to break that one. उस gap को भरने की कोशिश करिए, उस bitterness को खत्म करने की कोशिश करिए. Parenting एक art होती है and parents के angle से देखे तो उनके लिए भी ये जरूरी है कि they should understand their kids as well. So that is also another theme which can be taken, the sub theme of the chapter. So parents should also spend ample time with their kids, playing, laughing, having fun the way we see McDonald's having fun there. So it helps in strengthening the bond of the relationship. It is important. And if parents are not able to do that, children should also make an effort towards this. So we see that how Kezia, she actually had undergone a transformation. So now let us quickly come to the question answers. We will discuss those. You can do the matching. We can discuss it later. So here comes the first question, that why was Kezia afraid of her father? This we have already discussed. I hope this is clear to all of you. Right? Who were the people in Kezia's family? Yes, beta, Shrey.
In Kezia's family were Kezia's grandmother, her father, her mother, and Kezia herself.
And there was one more member, Alice.
And Alice the cook.
Yes, you will add Alice the cook, her name as well, right? Jee. Third question, what was Kezia's father's routine before going to his office, after coming back from his office, and on Sundays? So let's discuss the first point. Yes, beta, Manav. Manav, first point, before going to his office.
When before going to the Kezia's father's office, he often kissed to the Kezia, but Kezia not replied.
Yes, so before going to his office, Kezia's father would come into her room and give her a casual kiss, but Kezia, she would simply lie down, and this way only she would reply, goodbye, father. Next one, after coming back from his office, Parneet.
After coming back from his office, Kezia's father would ask his mother to bring his newspaper and tea in the drawing room and ask Kezia to pull off his boots.
Yes. Next one. On Sundays, Kashika. On Sundays.
On Sundays, he would stretch out on a sofa, sleeping soundly and snoring. He would enjoy a sound sleep on the sofa.
Yes, correct. Next one. In what ways did Kezia's grandmother encourage her to get to know her father better? Himanshi? Let me take Anamika's response. Anamika, yes.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, beta. Hanji.
Kezia's grandmother sent her to her father's room to have a nice talk with him. Yes. And give him a present for his birthday.
Yes. So first advice that she would suggest Kezia to go to the drawing room and have a nice talk with the father and mother. She would also suggest her to do different things for her father, like preparing a birthday gift for her father. Yes. Coming to the third part here, long questions, discussion. Just a minute. Kezia's efforts to please her father resulted in displeasing him very much. How did this happen? So you kaise hua? You will explain this situation. Harshit, yes, beta. Yes, unmute and tell what is the answer. Harshit?
Kezia used to be afraid of her father because her father talked to her harshly and in a rude way. Mm-hmm. Her grandmother told her to make a cushion for his father on his birthday as his birthday gift. Kezia took it as an opportunity to please his father, so she stitched a cotton cloth and cotton cloth.
It was a yellow silk cloth given by the grandmother, cotton cloth nahi hai. And she stitched
and, inside. And then she found.
Hanji.
And she had to fill that pillow with some stuff. So she found some sheets of paper, and on that the that paper was of her father's speech. And tore that paper into pieces and filled her pillow. In
it
that
was not
way,
a pillow it was a pin cushion.
Resulting.
And this way, she had actually destroyed the important papers, torn the important papers of her father, and she actually disappointed him. So this way, she created a disappointment. The next one is very important one. Kezia, she decides that there are different kinds of fathers. So what kind of father was McDonald, and how was it different from Kezia's father? Let's have a quick discussion. Yes, Rijul, beta, answer the question. Rijul. You can unmute, beta.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Quickly tell the answer. We just have 2 minutes.
Kezia realized that there are different kinds of father, and his father was one of the poor fathers who have to work and have no one to look after him. She thought that he was harder than grandmother, but it was nice hardness. He have to work every day. Also, she thought that Mr. McDonald is a happy man because he does not have to work every day.
Does not have to work every day. Okay, you will first explain Mr. McDonald. Okay, na? So you will explain that how Kezia, she found Mr. McDonald a very loving and caring father, right? They all looked happy that day when she saw them playing in the garden. And she found that he was a loving father who did not scold his children, who played with them. He was not cruel, Alice, as his father. So on the contrary, you will say that how Kezia's father, he looked different. He always treated her coldly and scolded her, sometimes even beat her. There was lack of conversation between them, right? And he would never play with Kezia as well. So this way you will elaborate the answer and compare both the fathers and justify the question. And dear students, now as the session is about to end, so we will discuss this third question on Monday next, right? So come prepared, and I will post one assignment today. That assignment you will do in your notebook. And we will have the discussion of these questions again, and then we will start with another topic. Okay?